crack-a-lacking party people, SARKAZZ here. why do I always bring like I'm on my review channel? What's up, y'all? We back in the building for a members only video. Shout out to T Smith for making these wonderful Q&A's possible. Hey, members, y'all scared? I appreciate T Smith here, but come on. There's more, y'all. Drop your video ideas. Hang out in the community tab. I'll be over there. Anyway, let's get into it. We got a couple of questions. Shout out to T Smith. I gotta get to the questions. Oh, we got 10 questions. What are 5 questions you'd ask someone on your first date? Well, off the top of my head, my questions be like, that would be before the date, you know, finding out if they were lesbian or bisexual. That's before the date. Not that it would matter. No, it matters to some extent, because I want to know what kind of bisexual you are. I have nothing against bisexual. I'm just saying, there's different. There's bisexual women that deal with men and women at the same time. And then you have bisexual deal with, if you're with a woman, you're with a woman, you're with a man. Yeah, that's my type of bisexual woman. You can love both, but you deal with one at a time. So yeah, that's before. Anyhow, are they employed? Last relationship? How many is that? 3 questions. I'm 46. I'm going to go. You got any STDs? Listen, this ain't the time. Now is you got your COVID to. It varies. Where do you live? Who you living with? It's a mad question. You only said 5. Girl. Number 2, if your new partner cooked for you and you didn't like the meal, would you be honest when they asked how it was? Hell yeah. 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 I can't hide. Yeah. Maybe even before the meal, you tell me what it is. I don't like that. I don't want that. Because I wouldn't want you to cook it for me again, thinking I like that. The fuck? Now, I'm going to be honest. I'm very funny with, you know, with textures and y'all be honest, because again, I don't want you to cook it for me again thinking that shit was good. Number 3, can you give 3 examples of someone showing love to you without them using words? Wow, that's a good ass question. What are 3 for me? Oh, without them using words. Wow, that would be showing effect. Okay, because you said without using words. Kisses. Like, I'm doing examples. I'm going back to my godbrother, going back to the other night. Kisses, hugs. That's 2. I'm thinking like thoughtful little shit, like. Just doing something for me, okay, without words, just doing something for me that they know that I love. Because I'm not a, I start thinking about, loving, I don't know, my mind went to that. But like for me, it would be just being there. Because my love language is quality time. Just being there. You don't necessarily have to be, you don't necessarily have to be doing something. Just being there. Just being, yeah. Hope that answers the question. Number 4, would you rather ask your partner for help or figure it out yourself? In parentheses, doesn't have to be financially. Now, personally, that's a hard thing for me. Not even just, you said your partner, so let me just stick with that. It's hard for me. And, you know, my partner knows the type of person that I am, so they know that I don't ask for help. I think, you know, I want to do everything myself. And so, I'm learning how to, it's not easy to, like, ease up, like, okay, to accept help. Even if it's just, not even the financial part, you know. See, yeah, you gotta know who you with, because I don't have that issue. We be battling to pay the check. No, but I'm saying, I don't have that problem. But yeah, hope I answered the question. But would I rather, it's not even would I rather, I don't know, it's just how I've been built. not can't say built. It's how I've been accustomed to being, if that makes sense. And you get disappointed a lot. You just don't really ask people for shit. Just do shit yourself. Number five. If it came up later in your relationship that... Where am I? If it came up later in your relationship that your partner slept with a good friend prior to meeting you, would that or would it not affect your relationship with both of them? Yeah, it would. Because my whole thing is, okay, you my partner and that's my good friend. Y'all did the do. Y'all both know. Y'all ain't tell me. I'm here dealing with you. All right, it's all good with you and I, but why y'all hiding that secret? If it's all that's underwater, under the bridge, it happened, you know, they know, fail hard, blah, blah, blah. That's something you can disclose. Why wait till late? To me, if you're hiding, it's like, why, you think my feelings are going to be hurt. But if it's something that's in the past and you moved on and da-da-da, yeah, share that shit. Now, would it affect the relationship? I'd be a little uneasy. I don't know if it's saying my trust. I'd be a little uneasy. Just questioning the fact is why both of you couldn't say anything if it, you know, it's something in the past. And then but then again, it's like, but you was with my friend. Why you want to be, see, yeah, I have a problem. Because you smashed my friend and now you want to be, you working your way around the circle? No, bye. See, I have a problem. I have to think it started to register. It's morning. It's 9:48. My mind is still waking up. Number six, would you stay with someone, make sure the camera ain't cut off, where am I? Would you stay with someone who got badly disfigured in an accident? Yes. The key in there is stay with someone. So that means I'm already with them. Yeah. This ain't, looks fade, all this shit fade. So, and a lot of things, you know, like questions like this, I had to put on myself. Because different circumstances, and you know, people will put, limitations or restrictions on who deserves love, who's deserving of love. Everybody's deserving of love. Everybody ain't gonna love everybody, but everybody's deserving of love. They're, you know, so going back to if someone's disfigured, you know, I'm with you, you disfigured, the fuck, okay? Your physical features change, but you ain't change. Yeah. And I put it on me because, like, okay, so say that happened to me. So wouldn't I want my person to stay with me? So why wouldn't I stay with the person I'm with? Now, yeah, that's the question you asked, and I'm going to leave it at that. You know, you didn't ask any, I'm going to leave it at that. Yeah, I'd stay. Seven, some people believe true love is unconditional. Does your love have any conditions? Everybody love have conditions. Let's stop the shit. Everyone love have conditions. Whether you want to believe, it could be the smallest shit. It has conditions. I'm human. I ain't Jesus. Does your love have conditions? Of course it does. Does it mean that those conditions stop the love? No. But everybody, you know, this is when you have, you. That's when that word compromise come in. But everybody love have, you ain't Jesus. Stop the shit. You can lie to yourself. Okay. Number eight. Oh, you may even want to, I don't have any kids. Someone say, oh, but I love my child unconditionally. Let that child go kill somebody. You may still love them, but there's something in there. Stop it. Stop it. Everybody, it can have, every love have condition. It could be the minute, small as a mustard seed. There's a condition in there. Like I said, lie to yourself. Number eight. Could you handle a relationship with someone that had a very demanding job, such as a doctor or police officer? Yeah, I could. Would it be difficult? Okay, hold on. Demanding job as a doctor or police officer. Yeah. Because I'm with someone that has a demanding job. Not as a police officer or a doctor, but yeah. Yeah, and I mean, and that's, we're like night and day in that instance, because they're a social butterfly. I'm not. Yeah, I'm not a social butterfly. I go to, you know, I'm in a place, I just be chilling, you know. I don't have to, I'm not all around in the center of it. That's not me. I'm just kick back and just chill. Well, I said, they're very out there. And I'm not the type of person, I'm with somebody and they're like in the limelight and I'm all up under them. I'm not that type of person, like, You gotta be, that's weird to me. That's weird. So, can I handle it? Yeah, I just be in the cut, like, all right, yeah, that's my boo. That, yeah, I'm good. I hope I answered the question. Yeah. Cause I'm kinda in that situation now. I just be chilling. As long as she know what it is, I know what it is. We good. I'm good. Where am I? Blah, blah, blah. That was number 8. Number 9. Do you prefer someone that is freaky or romantic or little both? Little both. We got to have a balance, you know. Or I could be the freak. That she could be the romantic. No, I'm a little bit of both. But I'm but no, yeah. A little bit of both. You got to have a balance. But number 10. T. Smith, I appreciate you. Number 10. Would you rather be stranded on an island with a stranger or an ex? In parentheses. Not necessarily the last ex, just the next. Because, girl, you know I'm about to say some shit. No. Is it read more? Is it read more? No, okay. Girl, stranded on an island with a stranger. Okay. I don't have a problem. Stranger or an ex, no problem. Not the last one. Stranger and ex, no problem. Because, again, I don't have many exes. And the exes that I have, I ain't got no animosity. And there's no animosity. There's no hate that nothing like that. It is what it is. Shit ain't work out. Okay? But, yeah, I don't got nothing. And, again, aside from that last, ain't none of the exes weird. They grown. They're not weird. And we respect each other. You happy? Cool. I'm happy? Cool. That's, I want to see people, just because we're, I still want to see you happy. I'm rooting for you. So, I don't care. We could be on the island. Cool. Just not that shit. Nah. Because, let me drown. Anyway. Shout out to T. Smith. Shout out to all the members of this channel for making videos like this possible. Yo, don't be scared. Don't be scared. Get your questions together. More than one question, members. More than one question. Get them together. Take some time and give them to me, you know. It's what I'm here for. I appreciate each and every one of y'all. It is 9:54 on a Monday. I'm about to go make some breakfast. If you don't believe me, yeah. I don't know if you can see that because we're 9:54. But, yeah, I'm about to get out of here. Y'all are amazing. I appreciate y'all. For real, for real. I'm out.